French fishing boats descended on Jersey this morning amid an escalating row with France over post-Brexit fishing rights. Dozens of French fishing boats gathered at the port of Saint Helier on Thursday morning for the protest. Two Royal Navy vessels, HMS Severn and HMS Tamer, have been deployed to monitor the situation amid fears of a blockade, and France has dispatched two patrol boats, Athos and Themis, to Jersey as tensions threaten to boil over. Some crews set off flares during the protests against a new post-Brexit licensing system implemented last week. Jersey fisherman Josh Deering described the scene at the port as like an invasion. He said the French fleet was mostly made up of big French dredgers and trawlers of 12 meters or more. Mr. Deering said, there were probably about 60 boats. There were a few handheld flares and smoke flares going off and apparently a few maybe bangers and stuff going off from the French. It was quite a sight. It was impressive. I looked from the shore this morning and it was just like a sea of red lights and flares already going off at sea. It was like an invasion. Later on Thursday morning, the leader of the protests asked the French boats to leave the harbor to let freight ferry the Commodore Goodwill depart. According to the Jersey Evening, Prime Minister Boris Johnson reiterated his unequivocal support for Jersey during a phone call with officials of the Channel Island. A Downing Street spokeswoman, the Prime Minister spoke to the Chief Minister of Jersey, Senator John LaFonda, the Deputy Chief Minister, Lyndon Farnham, and the Minister of External Affairs, Ian Gorst. This morning, the Chief Minister updated the Prime Minister on the latest developments with French fishing vessels around Jersey's coast. The Prime Minister reiterated his unequivocal support for Jersey and confirmed that the two Royal Navy offshore patrol vessels would remain in place to monitor the situation as a precautionary measure. They agreed to stay in touch as the situation develops. The row erupted after the Jersey government said French fishing boats would be required to obtain a license to fish in the island's waters under the terms of the post-Brexit trade deal with the EU, which came into force last week. The move sparked anger from French fishermen who complained boats which had operated there for years were suddenly having their access to the fisheries restricted. Under the new rules, French boats wanting to fish in Jersey's waters need to prove they have history of previously working there to keep operating. Jersey's external relations minister, Ian Gorst, said that of the 41 boats which sought licenses under the new rules last Friday, all but 17 had provided the evidence required. In Brussels, a spokeswoman for the European Commission said additional conditions attached to the new licenses represented a breach of the post-Brexit trade deal. The spokeswoman said, "We have indicated to the UK that we see that the provisions of the EU-UK Trade and Cooperation Agreement that we recently agreed have not been met there, have not been respected." Earlier this week, French Maritime Minister Annick Girardin threatened to cut off power to Jersey, which relies on France for 95% of its electricity, if the dispute was not resolved. Mr. Gorst stressed the need to find a diplomatic solution. He told BBC News, "We've heard disproportionate threats from Paris and now with a potential blockade, but the answer to the issues that are being faced are without doubt talking and diplomacy." Don Thompson, president of the Jersey Fishermen's Association, said his members have warned they are prepared to ditch their fishing licenses if the French win their demands. Mr. Thompson told Good Morning Britain, "We've already told our minister, our licenses. Some of our fishermen have paid £250,000 for our licenses. We're going to get rid of our licenses and fish without licenses. We just will not put up with those French boats being left to fish uncontrolled, unsustainably in our waters, whilst we're subject to all sorts of constraints." Dmitry Rogoff, who heads a group of Normandy fishermen, insisted they were not seeking to blockade the port. He said, "This isn't an act of war, it's an act of protest." In response to the protest, Frexit campaigner Charles Honoré Gallois hit out at the European Union, and a Jersey fisherman blamed the French government for engineering the demonstration. Meanwhile, Reform UK leader Richard Tice warned the French government must think very carefully over its actions. Tory MP David Jones branded France's threat to turn off Jersey's electricity more in keeping with the approach of Vladimir Putin's Russia than with a Western democracy.